Greetings to you, my people. My name is Ambassador Ayeba Abdullahi Adojo, the Eju Igala of Ataigala. I'm General Igala Ambassador of Ataigala. Today, I want to give us a brief lesson about the origin of Igala. Of course, in any history, there are various versions. And so, even that of Igala has various versions. According to some historians or researchers, some said Igala originated from Igbo. There is Jukun, there is Yoruba, there is Benin. Okay, so we're going to look at them one after the other, then tell us which one is correct among them. Number one is the Jukun origin. It was said that Igala migrated originally from Jukun, which Jukun is a tribe that I am Wukari, president of Otaraba state. That was the headquarter. Of course, that was a lie. Igala cannot originate from Jukun. It was stated, according to by Palmer, that when he came to the river Benue Valley, he met two groups of people, one Ahelgara and one Aheldenk, and that the Aheldenk told him that when they came to the area, they met Ahelgara, who are presently the Gala people. And so Igala had been here before the arrival of Jukun people. Apart from that, when Igala came, they settled first of all. When they came to Nigeria, present in Nigeria, they settled in a place called Borno, the Borno state now. And that place is called Ataigara people. Yes, some people have said that Ata as a title originated from Ida. No, Igala have been having Ata, Igala. They have been having Ata as their king. So the place they stayed in Boza, local government presently in Borno state, is the place they call Ataigala community. We also have some Igala that moved to Kebbi. They also call that place Ataigara. And the place we stayed in Taraba state, the place was also called Ataigara. In fact, it was called Tagara community. That was the second capital of Kwarafara after Santolo. And from the investigation, the person who ruled Kwarafara that time was Ata Igala, before the capital later moved. The last person to rule Kwarafara was the Akuka of Wukari. So again, looking at the culture, if you look at the way Ataigala is dressing and the way Akuka is dressing, it's not the same. Ataigala wears red and white crown, while that of Akuka of Wukari is not having that color. Ataigala has beans, has many feathers, okay, as the crown or Okebe. That cannot be found in the Jukun king. So, Igala, again, according to the Akuka of Wukari, he said that Igala did not have connection with Jukun. Not only him, Ata, Idako, Amelboni also confirmed that Igala did not have any link with Jukun. So some historians said that it was Abuteje, who was Jukun. But Abuto is not a Jukun name. Eje is not a Jukun name. Abuto is the child born when the mother had to look for baby up and down, okay, drinking such of medicine. Then we have Eje also. Eje is Leopa. It's even a title in Igala land. So there is no king called Aku, like we have Akuka. There's no king called Aku in Igala land. Why we have other kings or not traditional titles outside Kogi state or outside Kogi state that are having a title as Ata? One is Ata of Obosi. We also have Agabaidu, okay, of Abi. They are all over. So all these people are people from Igala. So if Igala migrated from Jukun, we should be able to have a particular title of Akuka. So Igala had been there before the Wukari people came. And it cannot be said that someone who came yesterday is older than the one who had been there for some years ago. The next one is Eri. Eri origin. So Eri was said to be the founder or the father of Igbo, according to some historians. Then according to the same people, it was said that Onoja, the son of Eri, was the founder of Igala. The question is this. Is Onoja an Igbo name? Is Onoja in the Bible? Eri has children such as Onoja, Onogu, Umieri, Iwedo. These are Bulu. These are the children, the names of the children of Eri. All these are Igala names. So this confirms that Eri was from Igala and not the other way around. This statement again was also confirmed by MCM Indigo in his book. And he said that Eri was an Igala hunter or warrior who came from Ida and settled in a place called Eriaka in the present day Aguleri, Anambra state. So that version again of Igala from Eri or Onoja was wrong, because Onoja is an Igala name, which means the king of many people. Why Onogu, the son, also means warrior. These are Igala names. In Igbo, war is Aga, not Ogu. So claiming that name was also wrong. Then in that case, to say that Eri was the father or Igala migrated or near from the Eri side, that version is also wrong and must be discarded. The next one is Benin origin. According to some historians, it was stated that the Eju Beja Ilo, the pectoral mask that Atagala is wearing, was given to Igala people by Oba of Benin. No, that was gotten from our war with them in 1515 to 1516. That was the first one where Igala invaded the palace, fought seriously, and brought the Eju Beja Ilo to Atagala as the sign of victory. And not to date, Atagala is still wearing the Eju Beja Ilo. So we're not giving, or we did not steal it, or we were never under Benin, let alone originating from them. They had another version which says that the Ata who fought the Igala Benin War was even Ata Aji, a younger brother or a brother of the Oba Isige then, the Oba of Benin then. So it is very clear that this is lie, because the person who fought the war was Ata Eboma Idoko. And when the war became very difficult, particularly the second time, when the Benin had to involve the Portuguese mercenaries, which came with various equipment that Igala could not withstand, the princess of Igala land, his own daughter, Princess Ayeboma Idoko, was buried alive. And up till now, the statue of Inikwe, where she was buried, is still in Ida, and that was during Igala Benin War. So to say that Aji fought the Igala Benin War, that was also completely wrong. In that case, that version of Igala originating from Benin was wrong. Igala has Egugu, or master that speaks Igala language. Benin people are not having that. Igala is having Osho, Benin is not doing that. Atagala is wearing a different crown from that of Benin. That of Benin looks to some extent that of Portuguese own. If you look at the burial of Ata, is different from that of the Oba of Benin. Atagala wears earring. Oba of Benin is not wearing earring. There is no connection there. The next one is Yoruba. Yes, some people said like Samajayan crowd that said that Igala was Yoruba, or Igala was part of Yoruba, or a group of Yoruba, or Igala is even Yoruba. That again is completely wrong. The nomenclature or the tribal name called Yoruba today came into existence in 19th century, just some years ago, around 200 years ago. It was given to the Oyo people, which many other people rejected. They were variously called, or those in Southwest then were Igala people, Benin, Nupe people, Ishakiri, Omo Odudua, Egun, Ijebu, and that was how they were variously identified based on their communities and the way they greet. The Igala people were called Anago, Nago, Nago, because that is how Igala greet. Why the Omo Odudua were greeting Aku, Eku, Eku, Eku Tojo, Kwaro. So that was how they got the name, according to the research or what I have read. This is subject to, you can investigate this. So now, unfortunately, because of giving the whole entire Southwest this umbrella name Yoruba in 19th century, all the Igalas and other tribe were known as Yoruba. Even the Anago people, those that the Igala that are greeting Nago, 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 were also called Yoruba. And if not now, many of them outside Nigeria, those in Cuba, Brazil, or other places, or even US, we identify wrongly as Yoruba because of that name. So Yoruba as a title or as the name of a tribe originated or came into existence around 200 years ago. Whereas Igala has been there even before the coming of the British, when they wrote the agreement between Igala that the slave trade should be stopped in 1841. We were called a Gara country. So the shine that was named yesterday can never be older than the shine named 20 years ago. That part again is also wrong. Like I have said, Igala has masquerade. The type of masquerade that Igala have, the Yorubans are not having. We have various different cultures. We are not related. And those that may be related in that place are those that are of Igala descent that are staying there but covered with the umbrella name of Yoruba. Then if all these are not correct, which version of Igala origin is correct? That is ancient Egyptian version. Igala originated from Egypt. We have many things in common. Different culture. Many different cultures that are the same. We also have different, many vocabularies that are the same. For instance, Ata is the same Ata, which means father, the great one. It also means elder. It means God. And it's the same way here. Then we have snake, which is Ejo. They call it Ejo there. There are plenty. coming or tell me. It's the same thing. Now they said here. So these are some of the vocabularies. Then apart from that, many archaeologists, ancient archaeologists, such as Pendry Flinders, Spencer Lewis, and many of them have said that Igala was part of the first dynasty, Pharaohs was part of the third, even the fourth, but Igala ruled completely in the 10th dynasty, or the 10th dynasty Pharaohs, which was between 2130 BC to 2040 BC. But how can we confirm this? The confirmation is there. If you look at the history or the culture of Atigala and the culture of ancient Egyptian Pharaoh, in Nigeria, Atigala is the only king that wears earring. This is what the ancient Egyptian Pharaoh wears. And the symbol is, it is a communication link between Atigala and God Almighty. That is the same thing that, or that is the same symbol, the same meaning in ancient Egyptian Pharaoh. The crown that Atigala is wearing, the white crown and red crown, Atigala has been wearing that right from ages. And that is the same crown of ancient Egyptian pharaohs. The pharaohs of lower, of upper Egypt, wears white crown. While those of upper Egypt, which is the Nile Valley, where Igala came from, wears the red one. And that is why all Igala traditional rulers wear red crown or red caps, because we migrated from the lower Egypt, the Nile Valley, around the River Nile. That was where we came from. So it is only Atta that is dressing completely just like Pharaoh in Nigeria. Then that is not all. The burial of Atta, when Atta dies, when any Atta joins the ancestors, he will be buried after 3 months. He had to undergo some spiritual exercises before the burial. And that was the same thing that happened in ancient Egyptian pharaohs. So when Pharaoh dies, he stays in a temporary resting place or temporary sleeping place until he doesn't wake up for 30 days or for 3 months. That was where he'd be buried. So it's the same thing that happened in Ida some months ago until the burial of our own Agabaido, Idapo Amelboni the second. And so again, Atta does not enter boat. That was the same, is the same thing with ancient Egyptian pharaoh. The ancient Egyptian pharaoh only enters king when they are dead. So when Atta or ancient Egyptian pharaoh enters a boat or a canoe or on water, it means they are already dead, because the canoe is to transport them from the side of life to the side of death. And so again, we use burial or funeral boat. In the, from my investigation in entire Nigeria, it is only Atta that is the same, that is he's the only king that is making use of funeral boat during his burial, the same way ancient Egyptian was doing. So when Atta dies, after the 3 months, he will be transported from his temporary resting place, okay, in our own is the palace, to the burial, the royal burial ground. In our own case, it's also Ojaina. So this happened around 6 or 7 days ago, when he was taken, our own king was taken to the burial place. And that was the exact thing that was happening in ancient Egyptian pharaoh. That when the pharaoh is will be buried, he will be taken in a canoe, sailed on River Nile from eastward or east side to western side. That east side is the side of life. The western side is the side of the ancestors. And so, with these few points, it can be shown, or it has been shown clearly, that Igala originated from ancient Egypt, but not also originated from ancient Egypt, because there are many tribes that in Nigeria that originated from Egypt according to their history. But Igala also ruled in ancient Egypt, and that is why the cultural practices, the traditional activities, the crown of Atigala, the wearing of the earrings, and the burial, especially the use of funeral boat of Atta, is the same as that of ancient Egyptian pharaoh. We are extremely ancient in Nigeria. We are extremely ancient, one of the oldest in Nigeria, and that is why we still carry and retain the ancient culture and tradition of Egyptians or pharaohs. And so with this is the little I can say on this. If you have a question, you can contact me on my Facebook page, Abdullahi Ayeba. So until then, I thank you all. My name again is Ambassador Ayeba Abdullahi Adojo. I want to greet all our Igala people, the Anag of Brazil that have connected of recently. Mr. Oliveira Williams, and other indigenous Igala of Brazil. Same way to those in Cuba that have connected. Our Ata people of India, we love you all. The Ata Igala people of Kenya and the Igala people of Ethiopia, we continue to unite and unite and unite. We know our origin. Igala originated from ancient Egypt. Thank you.